care. Hope you're ready for this universal health care thing. This is going to be great. Lawmakers keep telling us how much better countries like Britain and Canada and France, and all the people love it there. Tonight, here's the one thing that nobody on television is going to tell you about health care. America's health care is better than Europe's. Critics of our current system love to vilify the evil private corporations. They talk all the time, nobody has health insurance here. Really? How many times have you run over the person in the street that's got cancer just trying to crawl their way to some sort of help? They're in the hospital. You know, oh, all they care about is the bottom line. You know, the funny thing is, when there's a bottom line, the quality tends to improve, and the line you stand in gets a little shorter. I mean, let's please use some common sense on this one. Which one's better? When I say, hey, we're going to send your kids to a private school, or we're going to send your kids to a public school, which one? Hey, where's the bathroom? Oh, well, the private bathroom is over there. The public bathroom is over there. Which one are you going to? Private health care or public health care? Obviously, private is better. We know this. But for those who have been brainwashed by the pinheads in Washington, here are just a few ways in which our health care system is vastly superior to those oh-so-forward-thinking progressive countries we're apparently so desperate to emulate. Americans have a better survival rate for 13 of the 16 most common cancers than Europe. Take prostate cancer. 91.9% of men here in America live through it. If you have prostate cancer in Europe, oh, it's going to stink on ice. 73.7% in France survive. And God forbid you're in Great Britain, where 51.1% in Britain survive. Or every year, Britain's National Health Service cancels 100,000 operations. Okay, let's just play this out in our minds. You're like freaking out. I gotta have surgery tomorrow. I hope I don't die or they take the wrong leg. And what happens? Right before you go, hello? Yeah, we gotta cancel the procedure. Wait a minute. What? You don't want to have some bureaucratic bonehead who is only counting dollars and cents. And you certainly don't want to be standing in a long line like the 1 million Brits currently waiting to be admitted to a hospital. And another 200,000 just hoping, oh, please, I can't wait to get on that waiting list. We get annoyed here in America when it takes us 45 minutes to see a doctor, but at least we get to see one at the end of the 45 minutes. Are we really going to listen and follow in the footsteps of Europe? I mean, how many times do they have to goose step before we're like, we shouldn't listen to you guys? The place that gets a little bit hotter than usual, sometimes in the summer, like it did in 2003. I love this in Europe. When it gets a little hot, I don't know if they're trying to save the planet and so they don't have a lot of energy over there or whatever it is. But do you remember in 2003, it's a little hotter and people are like, oh my goodness, it's hot. We turn up the air conditioner. Over in Europe, 37,000 people died. Statistics show it's even worse in Canada. 800,000 of their 33 million citizens are on waiting lists for more than 18 weeks. That is twice as long as the blessed doctors in Canada consider clinically reasonable. Let me put this into perspective. That's like having every single person in Los Angeles, Chicago, and Seattle. Over 7 million Americans would all be on waiting lists. What are we doing? Why is this happening in Canada? Simple. Doctor shortages. Apparently, Canadian medical school graduates just don't want to make 42% of what ours do, and they don't want to work with all the bureaucracy. So what do? They come to America. What else is coming to America? How about the tens of thousands of patients a year, including the Prime Minister of Italy? If socialized medicine is so great, let me ask the Prime Minister, why did you come here in 2006? Why did you have your heart surgery at America's Cleveland Clinic instead of staying at home with your social? Did you know it's free over there? Before we trash our current system and in New York State, heap nearly a 60% tax on the rich to pay for health care. Just let's put this into perspective. You're making $1. This is what you keep. I'm sorry. This is what goes there. This is what you keep and you can spend. I mean, shouldn't we ask ourselves who in this country is going to innovate? Who, you know, greed is a bad thing, but a little bit of greed is a good thing. Somebody saying, gee, wait a minute, if I fix that, I could get rich. I got an idea. Why don't I fix that? Wake up, America. This is turning into a country I don't even recognize anymore. Our grandparents left Europe. They packed up everything that they owned. They left family and friends behind. They got onto ships and they came here to America to dream, to be free. They came to embrace the entrepreneurial spirit. They didn't come here. They didn't risk everything, work their butts off, only to have our dopey politicians in Washington say, you know, the mother country was pretty great. Our government is giving them the very government programs they were running from.